The thing that I was most annoyed about.
Danny Jolles and I were roommates for 2 years. Here's some behind the scenes from one of the Q&As at Nowhere Comedy Club.
I actually wasn't going to ask a question, but then you brought Danny in, so now I have to. What was other person's worst trait as a roommate?
Ooh, that's a good question.
I would actually say, and I'm not saying this to be nice, because, you know, that's not my thing. Danny was an excellent roommate, and I was really sad when he had to move out. I knew it was a matter of time, because, like, he and his girlfriend were doing really well. And, like, there was part of me that was, like, so happy for them, and part of me that was like, yeah, if they break up, he stays. and he was a wonderful roommate. He kept the common areas completely clean. He was very respectful. He was fun to hang out with. You know, I don't know if there was a I don't know, other than you didn't get the... You know what I would say the only thing is you didn't get the ancillary benefits of living with someone who, like, knew how to cook or anything, because, like, Danny didn't do anything.
Nothing.
That's
bring
part
nothing
of
to
why
the table.
He's a great roommate.
Zero. Zero yeah. on the cooking front. Zero.
The thing that I was most annoyed about was there was one time when it's, like, 3:30 in the morning and the doorbell rang and I was fast asleep. And I, like, shot out of bed, panicked. I'm like, what the fuck is going on? Mm-hmm. And I, like, ran down to the door, and there was, like, Chinese food. And I was like, what the fuck is this? And then I turn and I look, and Danny and his girlfriend are fast asleep on the couch. They had ordered Chinese food 45 minutes earlier, completely forgot, fell asleep. And then I had to, like, run to the door in my underwear to, like, get the Chinese food.
It was not good.
Yeah, it was just a one-time thing, but that's the one thing I can remember that I was like, "Fuck you," went back to sleep.
It was so funny because I remember it happening, me being like, my perfect record of never annoying Steve. I had a perfect record going, and I wrecked it for stupid Chinese food. I was so mad about it. Truly, what he said is true. It was very weird to be roommates with somebody for over 2 years, question mark, and never have, like, a real incident. Like, we both were very good at, like, we kept to our areas, we kept the middle area, like, common area clean, and we enjoyed talking to each other and, like, never spread outside of that. So it was lovely. Steve is organized. It might shock you guys to find out. And I will say, you do, there was a level of clean that he wanted that I did have to adjust to out of the gates, because it's like, it can't just go away. It has to go into the right spot. And if you put it in the wrong spot,
I'll never fucking find it. I'll never find it if it's in the wrong spot.
And see that, and you hear that every time. So you just start to adjust. A real spreadsheet of where things went at all times. But other than that, perfect.
I don't have a spreadsheet. But we were very friendly about it. I took the top cabinets. You know, like, we made sure that.
That's right. We sectioned off cabinets. That was our trick. Then we never got in an argument.
Thanks for watching. And thanks for subscribing on YouTube, following me on Instagram, and liking my page on Facebook. And of course, the Patreon. Patreon is one of the main ways I make a living right now, because I can't tour. If you want to support the Patreon and see videos before anyone else, go to patreon.com/Steve Hofstetter. You can also get some cool t-shirts there too, and video chat with me once a month. If you want updates on future tours, you can text the word Steve to 484848 if you're in the States, or you can text the word Steve to 393939 if you're in Canada. I still haven't found short codes in other countries. And of course, if you want to see me live right now, go to nowherecomedyclub.com. I do a 90-minute ad-lib show every Saturday night with Daniel Muggleton. I also perform full stand-up shows and do fun series like Director's Commentary, where I watch my old videos and heckle myself. Get your tickets now at nowherecomedyclub.com.